Hello, I'm Viraj Thorsekar. I'm a PhD student in Center for Ecological Sciences in Indian Institute of Science. And I work on predator-prey interactions, in the context of mate-searching behavior in crickets and spiders. Now, predator and prey are extremely common, and I'm sure you've seen prey escape predator attacks in dramatic fashion in nature documentaries. But have you wondered whether prey might not always rely on these last moment risky theatrics to escape predators? I'll explain using an analogy.
Instead of a predator and prey, let's say we have a police and a thief. Now let's imagine both of them are doing their job and the police is chasing the thief and the thief is trying his best to escape the long arms of justice. But this can potentially keep going on and on. But the thief can't only keep escaping the cop. He has to eat and take care of his family too. Now let's assume the thief is familiar with the landscape and knows that there are three villages in the vicinity. Here he plans to seek refuge from the incorruptible cop. Just to be cautious, the thief never stays in the same village as the cop. But there are costs to such vigilance. What if the thief was fast enough and sharp enough to escape the cop if they encounter each other? Would he then try and escape the cop only if they encounter each other in the same village? We asked a similar question with tree crickets and their predators, link spiders. They both inhabit bushes, which makes it an interesting system to study the spatial scale at which prey respond to and manage predation risk. Do crickets distribute themselves on bushes with no spiders present and hence avoid predators at the broad scale? Or are crickets oblivious to predator presence on the same bush? And do they evade spiders only when they encounter each other at the finer spatial scale? What makes this question even more exciting is that not all prey individuals behave the same. In crickets, males use long-range acoustic calls to attract females of the same species. But not all males in a cricket population call, and neither do all females respond to male calls. The ensuing variation in mate-searching behavior leads to different expectations from different individuals as to what spatial scale will they respond to and manage predation risk at. We conducted field sampling and performed enclosure experiments to find some interesting differences in predator evasion behavior depending on the sex and mate searching motivation of crickets. And of course, not always do the crickets manage to escape.